Anger's remorse is missing. Who took it?
Our shame becomes the pale horse. Oh, Tor, bro. Tor's love for you is in that song. That's why Cynthia wants it, to ruin him. She made Tor lust after her. We fought one scratching hag years ago. Now he's...
Cynthia targeted Tor specifically. Why? Where is Angus remorse now? Angus remorse. Where is it, Cynthia?
Drowned beneath dark water. Too many hands. The bathroom frightened her. Cut short. She screamed. An old folks' care home.
The Angus remorse record is in Cynthia's room, in her bathtub. Cynthia took the record and I brought it back.
Odin Anderson stirred in his bed, his vision hazy, smudged. He felt weighted down by an ocean of dark water. Through the haze, he made out Saga. Odin felt useless. He wished he could tell Saga how his silly faces made her smile when she was young. Too young to remember. Odin used to joke that Tor was her grandfather, but he was the Allfather. He smiled at the memory. Odin was the kinder of the Anderson brothers. Tor lacked patience, more volatile. The brothers fought a lot, but they were inseparable. Now Tor was missing, dragged into darkness. Odin could feel it. Time was running out for both of them.
Oh.
Ilmo was nervous. His palms were clammy. He lowered his phone. Mulligan isn't picking up. Yako shook his head, pointed at his own phone. Same with Thornton. Ilmo didn't like it. No one was answering the phone at the workshop in Watery either. Something was up. It had to be the writer. Had to be. The Koskula brothers were crouching in the bushes across from the Elderwood Palace Lodge, its light shining in the night. They couldn't wait any longer. The brothers knew Saga was in Watery visiting her trailer. Going now was their only chance to do this without hurting her. Ilmo stood up and a crowd of deer masks looked his way. Okay, this is it. The rider is the target. Take him down and it's all over. Only shoot the Fed if you have to. This is our big moment. We watch in the night. The crowd murmured the chant back to him. Ilmo turned his face to the hotel. He could see Saga's partner in the window. Ilmo slapped his brother on the shoulder. The brothers donned their masks. The cult of the tree was ready.
They're all so soft and sad. Do you know anything about the cult of the tree?
Yes, yes. He who reaches for a spruce tree will stumble into a juniper. Room was one of them. He has kicked empty. I wouldn't want to be in his shoes. But I like his shoes.
How did you know Blum was part of the cult?
Oh, Fox never runs out of tricks. He's a crazy man, and he will show his ways. Blum liked to talk. Crying in the dark place. What has been has gone. But trouble doesn't look like this. You can go to the basement and check the generator. But look out. You can never know in which tree the devil sits.
The basement. Thanks. Key fob's no good without power. There. Power's back on. Saga.
washed you away.
Hello there. Are you Pat Main from the radio?
That's me. And you're the federal agent everyone's been talking about. Would you have time for an interview at some point?
Oh, sorry. I'm kind of in a hurry right now. Love your show, though. Very informative.
Thank you. Never compromise on quality. That's my motto. We'd be happy to have you on the show anytime, me and my listeners.
Wheeler set up a foundation with the sales of their greatest hits album. He used the cash to build a nursing facility. The old men deserved it. An old manor in Bright Falls. Wheeler hired a contractor to have it refitted as an old folks' care home. At this point, Wheeler felt good about himself. He had a heart of gold. No need to feel guilty. Wheeler left the work to the contractor and returned to New York City. He had done his part. It was time to turn over a new leaf. The contractors figured out Wheeler was gone for good. They took the money and ran. When the fall rains came, the leak started appearing.
down? Was Cynthia into civil engineering? A lantern. Was Cynthia using it for protection? Did she know about the dark presence? A power station. Everyone needs a hobby, I guess. I feel like I'm missing some context here. I'm guessing the woman in this photograph was not Cynthia's favorite. The Dark Presence uses people's memories, their fears, to corrupt them. Cynthia was close to someone named Thomas Zane. Who is he?
Tom was back. Tom had enemies. In a fancy hotel. Just his imagination. The nightmare started to creep in. Cynthia Weaver smiled.
An old flame. Maybe Tom was taken. A bathtub, a pond, a lake. There's a theme here.
Cynthia would deal with the nasty Anderson fellow, Tor, always poking people with his hammer. He had it coming. Saga jabbed the selector on the jukebox. The missing record in its place. Saga couldn't have found it.
Anger's Remorse, by Old Gods of Asgard. I need to play it in the jukebox.
The dark water pressed itself into her.